Diandra, you've been a strong personality. Everyone knows you that you are vocal, you know, and still you have a Me Too story to tell. So,
I have
which
several.
Which means the predators not only target women who are weak, small towner, who probably wouldn't voice out, but they also target strong and successful women. Do you think this is abuse of power? Do you think there is this power play in the industry that they feel like I'm untouchable?
Firstly, what everyone needs to understand with the Me Too situation, and I'm seeing this happen a lot, okay, because I've been very vocal so far. I've not gone and spoke to too many people in the press. I haven't spoken to too many people. I'm very openly writing about it on my post, and people are sharing it, and it's going crazy and it's going viral. You know, everyone's confused. There's a lot of people who are high up, who are enablers. They're little like pimp mamas, little shielders. They're the breeders of, you know, of all this behavior. The big bad boy club, who maybe they also have some shady stories to share. Let's talk now. Why is Tata taking no action?
Yeah.
I'm calling him out. I'm calling you out, Mr. Ratan Tata. I've had like the biggest respect for your posts and the things that you've had to say. I'm calling you out. I'm calling your company out. Okay? Tavleen Singh, enabler. Some more name should I drop? Come, give me your excuses, give me your defenses, give me your justifications. Because, you know, my dear darlings, I have a feeling that since everybody knows this and he's been doing this in public to a lot of people, and everybody is enabling this behavior, then you obviously have something to hide if these are your defenses. Okay? Is it that the big bad boy club, the rich people, the journalists, the socialites, blah blah blah, that you're all probably, each one of you has a predator story? Or then maybe the women can't afford to buy the wives, and whoever else start to defend their husbands, like the Bollywood wives and whoever else and all these different clubs, because then what, how are you going to drip in diamonds, darling, and how are you going to afford that Gucci and that LV while you turn a blind eye to your husband's behavior? Yeah, today you think your kids are safe, okay, but your husband's probably doing this to some other minors or whatever. And there are enough and more stories on enough and more predators who, the stories are that when they were minors, many years back, this has happened to them, and today they are like wanting to come out, by the way. So be friggin' warned. And no, one second, let's call out the bullshit on everyone, okay? On all these enablers. My situation, तुम लोग चिल्ला चिल्ला के बोल रहे हो, सब लोग चिल्ला चिल्ला के बोल रहे हैं कि एविडेंस लाओ. टुमारो इफ आई एम इन सम शेडी लेन समवेयर, टुडे दिस हैज हैपेंड टू मी पब्लिकली, नॉट वन पर्सन हैज कम एंड स्टूड अप, ओके, टू बी माय विटनेस. व्हाई हैज नोबडी कम टू थ्री, अपेरेंटली 5 days बिफोर आई केम आउट विद माय स्टोरी. नाउ व्हेन आई केम आउट विद माय स्टोरी, नोबडी न्यू आई वाज गोइंग टू कम आउट विद माय स्टोरी एक्सेप्ट मी. ओके, 5 days before that, in Delhi, it was being discussed. Why? Because Suhail Seth's stories were being discussed already from the other women who came out. Yeah. I hate the word survivors and victims. I'm going to call them brave hearts, because it really takes
a courage.
You have no idea what we have gone through. I don't think I've had this kind of 75.5 shades of grey and purple under eyes in my entire life. Okay? You won't believe it. I've heard stories that they were discussing this incident that happened with me. Everybody remembers it. Everybody was talking about, I wish she had beaten this guy up. So, sabko yaad hai na, gossip ke liye sab gossip karenge. Then these women who are there on social media, who are defending these guys and saying, tum kya do raat ke 2 baje bhajan gaane gaye the kya? You went to sing bhajans in his room. So that means at 2 o'clock, if you've gone for a dinner party or something or whatever, blah, blah, blah. So you should not go to Suhail Seth, because why? Because there must be some shady story with him. That at 2 o'clock in the night, it's okay for someone to rape you. It's okay for someone to take their head and put it in your crotch. It's okay that someone will grab my boob. What? So these people, I'm calling out, forget the सुहेल तो मतलब उसकी तो बोलती ही बंद हो गई है.
Exactly, right. He's totally disappeared. And the man who's been so active on social media.
I should get an, we should get an award. जिन जिन लोगों ने सुहेल सेठ के बारे में बोला है, उनको तो अवार्ड मिलना चाहिए क्योंकि y'all are all in peace. उसको अभी सुन, nobody has to listen to his jargon anymore. The pseudo jargon. Okay, but what is everyone else doing? Now, everyone says, okay, so this is the question of the evidence. I believe, if you ask me, the fashion industry has so many of their, the people who are witness have God knows how many shady stories and they are possibly predators. So, I mean, now coming to these women who are shielding them and saying that the Me Too movement is women against these men. Hum to matlab pagal ho gaye and we are on some manhunt. Are you crazy?
Yeah.
I love men.
Yeah.
Are you mad? Please. I love men. Are you mad? Main kyu, kyu, why should I run? Why should I run with them? Then tomorrow to nobody, now to even worse, nobody will come and say anything to me. Pehle to people were intimidated. That means what, I'm supposed to like be single or what for the rest of my life? No, no, no. Listen, I love my men. I love my men and there are enough and more men in my life that are amazingly protective. Mm-hmm. One of my friends turned around and said, but if I was there, I would have pounded him even if I didn't know the woman he was groping.
Yeah.
Now right. That is a man.
That is the question.
That
actually.
Is a man. That is a human being who, even if they don't know who that woman is, they will come and step up. This is not a question of that. You know how many boys are there and how many stories are there.
Absolutely.
But they're not my stories to tell.
Exactly.
I will support it if someone comes out. But they're not my stories to tell.
So how can you even talk about
so
it?
So till you boys, I would like to tell you, this is not a sexist movement. Okay? This is... We are fighting a power problem. Nobody is handing us, men, women, children, nobody is handing us our power on a golden platter. Okay, you have to go out there and take that power. People are come forward. What is your scare? Financial scare? Wo to mujhe bhi tha. Na to main fashion ki rahungi, ya na to main Bollywood ki rahungi at this rate because I'm talking about all of it. At the end of the day, I will have no job left. I have dedicated 6 days of my life. I've changed meetings. I have, I'm not going to a event because I'm going to have to talk about this at, because with the press when it'll take away from what that job is.
Right.
Okay. So people are not, we're not doing this for publicity. Who wants this kind of publicity? We are talking to survivors. We are talking to anonymous people who want to come out and they are afraid. We are working on how do we... Let's question the right people.
Yeah.
There are girls, Kritika, who cannot file an FIR. Nobody is registering that. You all are telling us, were we sleeping? When Tanushri spoke and went and filed things, did anything happen this many years back? What the... Sorry for this language, but I'm going to fucking use this language because everybody needs to understand how angry we are. Let's question it. Why is everybody normalizing this behavior? And the boys, you need to come out. I'll tell you why. Because this has caused you your careers. This has outed you from these industries. You all have had to go and find other options, career options. Why when you all had the talent? The women... Why when we had the talent? Okay, we choose that we don't want to sleep. That's fine. The ones who want to sleep, let them do it. That's consent. They're doing it out of a choice. The ones who are not, why are they being, why are they being raped? Why are they being groped? I'll tell you why. Because we have let this slide. Everybody turns a blind eye. Everybody, whether it's happening to a boy, whether it's happening to a woman.
हमारे साथ नहीं हुआ है तो we don't want to talk about it. That's the attitude.
नहीं हमारे साथ हुआ है फिर भी हम नहीं बताएंगे क्योंकि पता नहीं क्या क्योंकि because this is the judgment from all you friggin' freaks and this people like Tavleen Singh who are in power to defend these motherfuckers. And Tanushri Datta, I would like to tell you one thing. I don't know you. I have never met you in my entire life. Of course, I know of you. And I have fought with some of my closest friends because they have put out disgusting posts dissing you, dissing women like you, saying that if you're a failed actress, why today are you coming and saying whatever? You have no idea how many girls, how many models. We have good friends with such people. We have all called her out in public on the post, and she's eventually had to apologize and remove those posts. Then there are some who personally believe different things, okay? The pseudo-feminists, the pseudo-empowered women. They know everything that's happening in this industry. I'm calling everyone out, from actresses, TV actresses, singers, web actresses, whoever the hell. I am calling each one of you out, designers, choreographers, everybody. I am calling everyone out, because on one thing, you will go on social platforms and say, we should be the change that you want to see, and empower, you know, women empowerment, yeah, and somebody something, and you're the first one to say, go for it, and all, yeah, of that. But you actually, none of you have the goddamn, I won't even use the word balls, because balls are weak. We should change that narrative. When they say, nah, don't be a pussy, that means you're supposed to be weak. A friggin' vagina can remove a goddamn, all these horrible human beings come out of a goddamn vagina. Okay, we are fighting for our children. You want to what? Harden your children and make them like me? Make them like, yeah, you're supposed to friggin' fight. You're supposed to, boys and girls. And that damage of all of those things is why human beings are like this. And this is the future. At this rate, I don't want to have a child. I don't want to bring a child into this world. And this is there everywhere. It's not just this business. Yes, the fashion and Bollywood is the most talked about. So, you know, what is going on? Really, what is going on? I'm calling out everybody. I'm calling out everybody, because y'all are all breeders, y'all are enablers, y'all have allowed for this behavior to continue. And now, not only has it stopped at groping, see, you understand, each one that has been called out, now each predator that has been called, I don't even call them men.
Yeah, true.
Okay, I don't even call them men.
True that.
Yeah.
Okay, they're predators. Each one of them, have you noticed, I don't know any of the women who have accused Suhail Seth. I don't know any of them. But everyone has a pattern. Each story has
same
a pattern.
Pattern.
A Sajid Khan.
Yes.
Right.
A Alok Nath. Yes. Alok Nath's case, to matlab, it was like, hum to sab jante the.
And
it's open on the sets. It's an open secret. Sajid Khan, open secret. Wow.
But I'm talking about predators. You know, whoever has been accused, either they have an explanation to give, either they have an apology, they have slapped legal notices to the accusers. And some have also said that I'm a monster, I'm sorry, and maybe I'm bipolar. But where is Suhail Seth? Where is Suhail Seth, and where has he disappeared? And the one who was so active on social media is nowhere to be seen after six women have put out allegations against
him.
And
now we can't possibly speculate as to where Suhail Seth is.
But what
now,
do you
we
make
don't
of it?
I don't roam around in those circles to start off with.
Yeah.
So we should start questioning the people from his social circle.
Right.
Right? So let's start calling them out. Instead of going on and on talking about the incident, acha chalo abhi ghisa pitaya sabko paalu main ki hua kya tha. I bit his fucking tongue and I grabbed his goddamn fucking balls. Yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
What more do you want to know? Now, please go and find him. What do you want to know? You want to know what color fucking chaddis I was wearing. You're calling me, you're hounding me. Not you, I'm saying generally.
Yeah.
As a journalist, should your job not be to go and find this guy? One to journalist went to the extent of asking me for Suhail Seth's number in the end of the thing. Phone call.
I don't have
it. Yeah, what do you have to say? Please tell me. Please tell me what you have to say. Okay, we can't go and complain. Because then they want... So if you're in some dark gully, we take your rickshaw somewhere.
Yeah. Right.
And this guy decides to molest me. I'm supposed to be like, okay.
First,
hey, yeah.
This angle is great.
He's
molest me. Main evidence leke dete tumko. That's the fight.
That's the fight.
Okay, yeah. We know, I know, of stories where male models have been harassed. But I was not there when they were getting the messages.
Yeah.
I was not there when somebody dropped some pants, or when the some fitting for some show was happening and somebody grabbed someone's crotch without his permission, or I was not there, na?
Yeah. Right.
So if I'm listening to gossip, wo gossip rahega, but the point is, I can't say that story. I can tell you my story.
Yeah.
Right? This way I can expose 10 other people in this industry, but they are not personally my stories. Yeah. You see? But everybody knows. So let's, and then some people are like, why is only Bollywood getting attention? Why is not fashion industry getting attention? Arey bhai, ye competition nahi hai. It's not a competition. If you have something, mo kholo. Everybody is waiting for somebody to open their mouth. Because everybody has become a sheep. This is our problem. Sab na followers hai. Nobody wants to take an initiative. I came out with this. I didn't need to. I came out for solidarity with these other women.
Yeah.
I came out to the point, if you ask me, what do you want for him? Okay.
Right. Yeah.
The ones who had these incidents where, you know, some boob has been groped or whatever else, and it's not something has come to my crotch and he put, you know, whatever. They feel differently. They're like, if he gets sacked, it's okay. You know, they're a different... Everybody's a different person, right?
Right.
So you have, and everything that's happened to you. Now, someone who's been raped will obviously want a more severe punishment.
Absolutely.
Right. Right? But everybody is all helpless. Now, what's happening is, it's angering you, other women, when you know it's the same predator.
Yeah.
And he's done this, and it's worse, and he's getting away with it. So more people are like, you know what? Screw you. Now I will also jump in it. And you know what? There is some serious loss of time that goes into this.
Right.
I have hardly slept. I have lost my appetite because I feel sick to my stomach when I'm hearing stories day in and day out. I'm reading them. I'm talking to survivors. It takes a toll on you.
Absolutely.
Right.
That's another trauma you
face. It takes a toll on you because you realize that you have to also... You're expected to be strong because you have this reputation. I have woken up every morning and screamed and said, howled and said, please give me a sign, universe, that this is the right thing that I'm doing, because I know the fear that everyone is facing. I have the same fears. I might die and nothing may happen and nothing may change for the future. The point is, I've howled and I've said, give me a sign, universe. Give me some sign that this is the right path, because I feel like it is from the bottom of my heart. But what is the sign and what is that path ahead that I'm supposed to take?
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. I've said the story. Okay, fine. I cannot talk to anybody anymore and say, bas, but my story is out, yaar. Okay? But there's a much larger cause that we are fighting for. Yeah.
It's not about one
not about one man. It's not about woman versus man. It's not about whatever. It's about such a... And the fight is huge, because not only we are fighting this power play, we are also fighting our own fears. We are fighting patriarchy. We are fighting misogyny from women. From intelligent, educated people. We talk about uneducated. So what are we, you know, we're fighting so much. And you know, I howled. And every day, I get answers. Because I have people from, I don't know where, coming out. All the worries, all the fears. That how, who, which are the lawyers? I can't afford a lawyer. I can't afford to be running to, everybody's coming out. They're coming and they're helping you free of cost. All you have to do is speak your truth. That's all. And we are all there. We are helping each other through this process. You know what all of us discuss, the survivors? We're discussing, can you please hydrate? Just remember to switch your phones off and take some time to yourself.
Be mentally healthy.
Okay? Because it's another fight, a new day. Take some time off. You know, some people's parents are not talking to them, because they went ahead and filed this. Some women's children are being bullied in school because it's so publicly out there. So many different things. So many. Plus, you have to go to work. Plus, you have to deal with your husband. Plus, you have to go home and look after kids. What? Anybody wants this kind of attention? It's draining. I'm exhausted. But I still can't sleep. Because you know what? I'm not done. And if this sucks my blood, if it sucks my blood, so be it. But I will do my damnest best, because tomorrow I can stand proud, look at myself in the fucking mirror and say, I at least tried.
Yeah, right.
I tried, man. fuck you all.
The basics of having a safe environment for women.
At least I'm walking my goddamn talk.
Yeah.